Hi, welcome to the test. We're here in Brighton Hove to test out the most efficient, most cost-effective and quickest way of travelling across the city. We'll be pitting three modes of transport to the test. A 2008 Volkswagen Polo, Brighton Hove's award-winning bus service and Thomas on a bike. We will begin the test from here, Hove Lagoon, and finish 4 miles east in Brighton Marina. Taking the bus will involve a 5-minute walk to the bus stop. Sean will have to get on 2 buses to get to the marina. Thomas will face a 4-mile bike ride, whereas I'm restricted to 30 miles an hour. Right, all ready? See you at the marina, boys.
I am on my way to get my first bus, the number one to George Street.
About 5% of journeys in Brighton and Hove are done by bicycle.
It's okay. Hit by the first red light. This car emits 139 grams of CO2 per kilometre. That's the equivalent to the life cycle of 9 iPod Nanos. Oh, not another traffic light. This is a game of cat and mouse.
I got off my first bus, walked up George Street, and caught my second bus, the number 7.
By cycling, I was emitting no carbon dioxide. That's the equivalent of, well, no iPod Nanos.
The bus releases 89 grams of CO2 per kilometre per passenger. That's the equivalent to the life cycle of only 5 iPod Nanos.
Now, by driving along the seafront, I'm restricted to 30 miles an hour. And the device restricts me to 30 miles an hour?
I cycled along National Cycle Network 2. Brighton Hove is one of the UK's 6 cycling cities, and their cycle lanes stretch for over 40 kilometres.
Brighton Hove Bus Company were awarded Operator of the Year for 2009.
Meanwhile, I thought I'd stop for a quick break. Maybe not.
As Thomas pushed on, I was driving closer to the marina.
How'd you do that? Well, you know, it's nothing really. 4 miles.
won. So Thomas won on his bike, but how did he compare on the test?
Back to the studio.
It's freezing.